Redux is a predictable state container for JavaScript applications. It helps you write applications that run in different environments, client, server, and native, and are easier to test. You can use Redux together with React and also call React Redux. React Redux is tiny, about 2 kilobytes, including dependencies, but it has a large ecosystem of add-ons available. Modern web applications are composed of multiple components that constantly produce and share data called state. States are decentralized, so it can be so difficult to manage. React Redux was created by Dan Abramov and Andrew Clark. For Redux to work correctly, the state must be immutable. Redux has a single global object to store or share application state. When a button is clicked, an action will be dispatched. It has action name and payload. Because the store is an immutable object, so in order to change the application state, a new object is created from the current state and payload object. It is performed by a reducer function.
The reducer passes the current state and payload as input parameters. It returns a new object as new state. The Redux flow is a one-way data flow that is predictable and testable. React Redux also gives developers some perfect depth tune which allow you to travel around the application data.
But the boilerplate code seems quite complex to understand and quite difficult to small project to get started. So start with creating new React application with React Redux Redux toolkit firstly. The store register multiple reducer, then provider make store data accessible to entire application tree of component.
A store is basically just a plain JavaScript object that allow components to share state. We define store.js.
This file is created from config store function
and some reducers.
We will define reducer later.
A slice automatically generates
action creator and action type that correspond to the reducers and state. Initial state are always not null. In this case, it is an array of products.
Reducers here have two functions. Insert and delete object product in an array. You can destruct two action from product slice action, then export default reducer in your real project. We have many more components except app. This component can access store globally. You should probably prefer to call the use dispatch hook in your components to retrieve a reference to dispatch function. This button will dispatch an action using dispatch function. The provider component makes the Redux store available to any nested component that need to access the Redux store. Use Redux Debugger by pressing F12. You can see the Redux flow from action to reducer, then update state, then reload use interface.
The advantage of Redux is that we can select data anywhere in the application. We can also observe any reactive value of slice in the store with the user selector hook. It is all about React Redux with a tiny example. It may help you understand quickly about Redux and Redux DevTool. If you like this video, please comment, subscribe, and share for receiving more videos. Thank you all.